Welcome to the MSPT's online learning course in Emerging Trends in Electronics. MSPT lead learning at your doorstep. I, Mr. Pramod Mense, lecturer at Sri Siddheshwar Women's Polytechnic Solapur, presenting you first unit advanced processors. And unit outcome is describe the given advancement in the processor architecture. At the end of this presentation, student will be able to explain processor controller selection criteria for particular application. Have you heard about processor or controller? Do you know Moore's law? Okay, we will get these answers in today's presentation. The today's presentation contents are introduction, processor or computing, Moore's law, and different processor selection criteria. This shows concept map of processor selection criteria. Primarily, there are three categories or three criteria. On these basis, we can select particular microcontroller or processor for application. Processors have undergone a tremendous evolution throughout their history. A key milestone in this evolution was the introduction of the microprocessor, term that refers to a processor that is implemented in a single chip. The first microprocessor was developed by Intel under the name of 4004 in 1971. It contained about 2300 transistors, was clocked at 740 kHz and delivered 92,000 instructions per second while dissipating around 0.5 watts power. Since then, practically every year we have witnessed the launch of a new microprocessor, delivering significant performance improvements over previous ones. The complexity of an integrated circuit is bounded by physical limitations on the number of transistors that can be put onto one chip. Advancing technology makes more complex and powerful chips feasible to manufacture. Let's see the term processor. In computing, a processor or processing unit is a digital circuit which performs operations on some external data source, usually memory or some other data stream. The CPU is the brain of a computer. It takes the input data, processes on it, and gives the result. It follows instructions of computer programs. Microprocessor can be implemented on a metal oxide semiconductor integrated circuit, that is IC. If you zoom it, you can see the central processing unit, RAM, ROM, different IO peripherals, clock circuitry, along with CPU. This entire circuit is manufactured onto a single silicon chip. In this picture, you can see this integrated circuit inside view. Let's see Moore's law. Moore's law is the observation that number of transistors in a dense integrated circuit doubles about every 2 years. Moore's law is an observation and projection of historical trend. Moore's prediction has been used in the semiconductor industry to guide long-term planning and to set targets for research and development. Advancement in digital electronics, such as the reduction in quality adjusted microprocessors,
the increase in memory capacity, the improvement of sensors, and even the number and size of the pixels in digital cameras are strongly linked to Moore's law. These step changes in digital electronics have been a driving force of technological and social change, productivity and economic growth. Numerous kinds of processors and various designers are available for digital systems. The first and foremost criterion in choosing a processor is that it must meet the task efficiently and cost effectively. Following considerations need to be factored during processor selection for digital systems. Performance considerations, power considerations, memory units, peripheral sets, operating voltage, specialized processing units, and price. The first and foremost consideration in selecting the processor is its performance. The performance speed of processor is dependent primarily on its architecture and its silicon design. Evolution of fabrication techniques help packing more transistors in same area, thereby reducing the propagation delay. Also, presence of cache memories reduces instruction data fetch timing. Pipelining and superscalar architectures further improves the performance of the processor. Multicores are the new direction in improving the performance. Core mark is one of the best ways to compare the performance of various processors. So, size of cache, processor architecture, instruction set, etc. has to be taken into account when comparing the performance. The next criteria is power consideration. Increasing the logic density and clock speed has adverse impact on power requirement of the processor. A higher clock implies faster charge and discharge cycles, leading to more power consumption. More logic leads to higher power density, thereby making the heat dissipation difficult. Further, with more emphasis on greener technologies and many more systems becoming battery operated, it is important the design is for optimal power usage. Some hardware and software methods are adopted to save the amount of power. The next criteria is memory. For storing data, we need data memory, and for storing code, we need program memory. That is the amount of RAM and ROM on chip and off chip. Internal memory is typically the most cost effective memory type, but it is also the least flexible. Cost is always a factor. The microcontroller with the least amount of memory to fit the application is typically selected. Therefore, care must be taken when predicting code size, since an increase in code size might require a different microcontroller. The next criteria is peripheral set. Every system design needs, apart from the processor, many other peripheral for input and output operations. The number of I/O pins and the timer on the chip, necessary peripherals provided on chip in system on chip architecture for effective data communication using direct memory access.
The next criteria is specialized processing units. Coprocessors execute the instruction faced by the primary processor, thereby reducing the load on the primary. Some coprocessors are floating point coprocessor, graphic processing unit, digital signal processors, etc. Floating point coprocessor supports primarily integer only instruction set. Hence, presence of floating point coprocessor can be very helpful in application involving complex mathematical operations including multimedia, imaging, coders and decoders, etc. Graphical processing unit, also called as visual processing unit, and it is responsible for drawing images on the frame buffer memory to be displayed. Since human visual perception needed at least 16 frames per second for a smooth viewing, drawing for HD displays involves a lot of data bandwidth. GPUs have become a mandatory requirement for various mobile phone and gaming consoles. Digital signal processors are specifically designed for signal processing applications. Its architecture supports processing of multiple data in parallel. It can manipulate real-time signal and convert to other domains for processing. It is possible to use DSP along with a processor or use the DSP as the main processor itself. The next criteria is operating voltage. Each and every processor will have its own operating voltage conditions. All the desired ratings or standard ratings are provided in user manual or data sheet. While higher end processors typically operate with 2 to 5 voltages, including 1.8 volt for cores and 3.3 volt for IO lines. The next criteria is cost per unit. This is important in terms of the final cost of the product in which a microprocessor is used. The next criteria is availability of software development tools like assembler, debugger, a code efficient C language compiler, and different hardware and technical support is required. The third criterion in choosing a processor is wide availability and reliable sources of the processors, like analog to digital and digital to analog converters, memory chips, diagnostic ports, serial parallel ports, and some auxiliary systems. These are some manufacturers, those who are producing the microprocessor and microcontroller chips. Let's summarize today's presentation points. Processor is selected in embedded system based on three basic criteria: performance based parameters, availability of software tools, availability of different resources. For more learning, students are requested to attempt assessment sheet given in the e-content. Thank you.